Thank you so much. Tunisia is a lower resourced country than most of the countries represented here, but with a developed strategy of primary health care centers. So this is the first systematic screening of autism spectrum disorders in Tunisia, and we have no standardized screening of monitoring for the developmental disorders in the country for the children under 3 years, and of course no prevalence study, no prevalence study that have been conducted before. So our aim was to take advantage of the immunization system, which is very common in Tunisia. 97% of children, for example, at 18 months receive the immunization to implement the systematic screening of autism. This was the aim of this study. So it was a simple design. We had a cross-sectional design over seven primary health care centers in two districts, mainly consisting in 1 million inhabitants. So we picked them up with the cluster samplings, and then we took all the consecutive children coming for the immunization at 18 months. We proposed them to do the screening, and all of them accepted. So all the children were accompanied by a caregiver, mainly the mother. And we had 866 children over the 6 months period, which was the period we were planning to carry the study on. So the MCHAT was systematically filled by the caregiver. The MCHAT was an instrument that had been previously translated and validated to Arabic through a 9-country-wise study that had been published before. And we insisted upon the fact that the parent should be assisted by a caregiver, by a professional nurse who has been trained to the instrument before. So we had to check again after the ones who were positive. That's the first check with the phone check with the MCHAT, and then the ones who are still positive received the clinical evaluation with the child psychiatrist with the ADR as an additive objective evaluation. So these are the results in blue. And we chose to put some comparison with similar studies, with the one in Spain and the one, the original study by Dinah Robbins in Connecticut in the US. So we had, after the first screening, 12% of children who were positive, which was a high rate. And then after the phone check, this rate dropped to 1%. These 8 children, representing 1%, have been assessed, and 3 of them received the diagnosis of autism spectrum disorders with accordance to the ADI 3 dimensions above the threshold. 2 of them had other developmental delays and 2 are normal. And as you can see, these results are much closer to the study in Spain, which was a bigger study with 3,000 children at the beginning, than to the ones in the US, where you see that, for example, the drop of the number between the first MCHAT screening on the field and the phone check was not as high as we had, or as the Spanish study found. So our final comments is that, of course, we have a lot of limitations in respect to the small sample. We had the intention to enroll more than 1,000, and we enrolled that, but one of the primary healthcare centers was not very reliable when we compared the results with another instrument that I'm not showing here, but is the CBCL, the preschool CBCL, for the withdrawn subscale. And focusing on the 18 months only, which was an obligation because this was the age at which we received the children for the immunization, made us miss the ones who will be regressing after between 18 and 24 months, representing, as the literature says, 25% of all the cases of children with autism. The strengths are that this is the first systematic screening in the region, so it's a screening using standardized measures and procedures which can be implemented easily in the general healthcare system without any additive costs. And the other comments is that the prevalence seems not very far from the usual range. So today and yesterday, with some of the intervention, we know that it is growing to 1 to 150, but This is the usual rates we received in the beginning of the years 2000, and it's more similar to the Spanish study than the other studies. And the final comment that I didn't put here, that it raises also the access to the diagnostic instruments for some countries, which is sometimes difficult and hard. Talking about the ADI in particular, so I must confess that the ADI he was used by myself, but I received just a partial, you know, training to ADI during a short stay in US with the team, some of the people, you know, Steve Booter, Jeff Salt, and Jennifer Korski. But this doesn't allow me to say that I'm, you know, formally trained to ADI, but it was a limitation that we accept that this week of work. Thank you so much.